Before the video starts, I very quickly wanted to mention that Riot fixed the issue with the Star Walking copyright. As I mentioned in the last video, it was most likely an unfortunate mistake. So everyone's videos should start reappearing again. And now, on to the news. Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Rift News, the show you are most likely going to watch because you wanna know what's happening around worlds. Or you are very thirsty about the new Ahri. Thankfully for you, you will see both today. So as always, let's start with what is happening in League of Legends. As we all know, worlds are now in full swing. And just by watching them, you will get some capsules, which include some really interesting loot. As we mentioned last time, besides icons and emotes, there are also new chromas. In addition to this, Riot also released the new Content Creator Guidelines for Worlds 2022. According to this, creators will be able to react to the world's broadcast after each day finishes. So you can't do a live reaction, but you can do it the day after. Streamers can also save up to 3 clips of maximum 15 minutes per game, but Riot's partner logos must be visible at all times. That one is not really that surprising. And finally, the music of the broadcast must be muted. I'm not really sure how you're supposed to do that while keeping all the rest of the audio, but thankfully no music is playing during the games. Now, during the last news, I was joking about how my pickems are gonna be horrible. So of course, I just forgot to do them at all. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but picking the winners was not opened yet. But you were able to do the crystal ball predictions. For those of you who don't know, these were special predictions that would give you extra points on top of the normal guesses. And these predictions are based on what would generally happen during Worlds. In the Champions category, you can predict what champion will be picked the most, who will be banned the most, who will have the highest win rate with minimum 5 games, who will be played the most in different roles, and who will have the most deaths. In the players category, you were able to guess who would have the highest KDA, who will play the most different champions, who will get a pentakill, who will have the most first bloods, and who will have the most kills in a single game. Notice how there is not the lowest KDA or anything negative. Riot is fighting toxicity well. In the teams category, you can guess who will win, who will be first place in groups A and B, which team from the smaller regions will place highest, and which team will play most different champions. And lastly, in the event category, you can guess how many reverse sweeps there will be, how many pentakills there will be. You could also predict the duration of the longest game, how many Baron steals there would be, and which Drake will be slain the most. Now, of course, as I mentioned, worlds are in full swing. And each year that also means new merch. Instead of the slightly sporty style, they went full on to white, blue and skin color, so that you can pretend you are wearing the skin of your enemies. It's worlds after all. You can also get the new Tibbers, which had seen all sorts of shapes and sizes at this point. There are also new jackets, jackets without sleeves for Tyler 1, ponchos, joggers, a really, really odd cap, but I have to point out that every year they get a new hoodie. And these hoodies are always high quality. I've been buying these since 2017. If there is one thing I would recommend, it is the hoodie. Besides clothing, there is also the new Championship LeBlanc, which is to celebrate the championship skin. And remember all those premium expensive statues from the other studios? Well, now you can buy them directly through the merch store. So if you're interested in the new Zyra, Elementalist Lux, or Fiora, who also has the LED light-up crest background, just know that you can also get them here. Lastly, we should mention that the Infinite Studio, which is responsible for the Fiora and the Zyra, is also making a new 3D frame of Lux. I believe this is their second one since they already made Miss Fortune. But besides the merch and the loot, worlds are also dealing with another interesting thing. The worst became reality when someone at Worlds tested positive. But it seems like Riot has it at least somewhat figured out. In this scenario, the positive player has the opportunity to play from an isolated booth. This booth is not located on the stage, we are not in a zoo after all. It will most likely be in a different building. But instead of the entire team surrendering straight away, they can still play with that one player joining from a distance. Although this is still definitely a handicap. Since before the games happen, that player will have no other ways to communicate with his team other than Discord. So both from a morale and a tactical point of view, it is a disadvantage. So let's see if it reflects on how Worlds turn out. Next, besides merch and Worlds, we also have some gameplay. Because Ares ASU was finally revealed. It's not on PBE yet, but Riot talked about it in a post. At the start, they talk about how the ASU doesn't change her gameplay. And how they are updating all her skins too. You know, things we already know. They then talk about how the narrative inspired her visuals. And how the overall ASU required 4 steps. They had to dig into the already existing content, understand what people love about that character, create pillars of her personality, and write the final voiceover. Since Ahri is an already established character and since she appeared in the massive Ruined King story, they wondered if her ASU should take place before or after the Ruined King game. And in fact, even though in Ruined King she looks a lot more battle ready, the new Ahri will be her new post-Ruined King version. Which means, be ready for some spicy interactions with Yasuo. But also she will finally acknowledge the Vasani in-game. Unfortunately, Riot did go for the most played out aesthetics. With her main inspiration apparently being the very old cinematic A New Dawn. In reality, most of us will connect her new visuals to something like the HD version of Wild Rift. It's just higher resolution Ahri. This alone wouldn't really make the ASU noticeable though. And that's why Riot gave her tails a new tech. Each tail now has its own rig and it can be individually animated. But they also have the ability to blend into each other, so that they can appear as a single tail. Sort of how like Irelia's blades work. And the fluidity of these animations is amazing. All you need to do is to look at this presentation to see how great they are. Also, her tails will now have physics, which is sort of a norm these days. The tails will follow her just like how Aurelian's tail follows him. And finally, when it comes to her tail animations, Riot wanted to form her tails into a heart for her charm. The issue is, the moment you would turn the model, you would not be able to see the heart. And that's why Riot gave her 4 different animations, one for each direction. So that no matter in which direction you are casting charm, you will always see the heart. Next, we also got to see her spell effects. Now you can see the weight of her Q as she's throwing it out. And you can now also finally see the exact size of her Q. Also, her orb is no longer statically attached to her body. Instead, it will now float around her hand as she moves around. Her W now takes a curved path towards her enemies, which makes the ability feel more alive. And again, her E is very important, so it is amazing to see that we can now properly see it. And lastly, her sound effects were lightened up a bit, so that it actually sounds like ghastly magic and not someone beating a bubble wrap. Well, since the time I recorded this, Riot revealed yet another PBE patch. And oh boy, is there a lot here. From the skins, we are getting a new batch of Bewitching skins. That's on top of the Fright Night skins, which are also Halloween skins, I guess. But the Bewitching skins will be connected to the World Store and its tokens. Here we have Bewitching Nico, which looks and sounds amazing. I know that all the Bewitching skins are witches, that's why they all have hats. But in this skin, Nico is supposed to be a cat, and I think if she didn't wear a hat, Riot would be able to show it better. But this is absolutely an amazing skin regardless. The same goes for Bewitching Cassiopeia. Not only are the spells great, but the model itself is stunning. I absolutely love the glowing magical tail. Then there is Bewitching LeBlanc, which is the weakest of these skins. It is a decent looking skin. I'm just wondering, she is a witch. Why is she not holding a broom? Both Janna and Nidalee have brooms. Why not LeBlanc? Then there is Bewitching Senna, The idea of this skin is that her weapon is actually a monster that's alive, and it works really well. I also love that she turns into a ghost with bats around her, and the entire idea just works. And lastly, there is Anivia. Once again, this is a gorgeous skin. Now, at first I was confused, why does she have a coat and a hat? In this skin, Anivia is a bat. So surely it would be way better if they just fully leaned into it, and they didn't give her anything and they just turned her into a bat. However, people pointed out that the hat and the coat are quite clever here, because the tip of her hat mimics what her beak would look like, and the coat mimics the feathers on her tail. So here she is not a proper bat, because they needed her silhouette to still look like Anivia. And although I would like it if it was just a normal bat, this is still a gorgeous skin. Next, this patch also finally showed us 3 Honors Malzahar, which is your reward for being honorable. It is an electric futuristic take on the World Ender skin line, and it absolutely works. It reminds me of a cyberpunk version of the Godfist Lee Sin. And of course, the 3 honors are the 3 honors you give your teammates at the end of the game. Then, this patch also introduced a brand new Mythic Roma. This time it is for High Noon Senna. So far, these Mythic Romas were always great. They always give the base skin some extra glee, and they also enhance the abilities. And this time we are getting a light blue version of the normally dark High Noon universe. And then we learned that this patch is also testing the new preseason 2023. Many people already talked about this. And in fact, I would recommend watching Tyler's reaction to this post for more details. But for this video, just super quickly, Chemtech Dragon is back. It will give you tenacity and extra healing and shielding, with the Chemtech Soul giving you extra damage when you are low on health. Chemtech Drake will also chemically augment the plants on Summoner's Rift. While mutated, Blast Cone gets double blast range, Honeyfruit no longer slows you and instead gives you a shield on top of the health, and Scryer's Bloom gives you movement speed towards revealed enemies, and it reduces wards to 1 health. Next, a big change is that junglers are able to buy eggs that spawn a pet for you. After killing a certain amount of monsters, these pets will evolve and buff their owner. There are 3 different pets. Noxian Embercat is an aggressive pet that gives you slows and bonus damage. Ishtali Isamander is a defensive pet that gives you a shield and tenacity. And Ionian Cloudleaper is a roamer's pet that gives you bonus movement speed. Next, Riot is also trying to make jungle an easier role with their 2 new iterations. Camps will now visually show you how far they can be leashed, with the leashing radius being shrunk down so that you are no longer forced into pulling 2 camps at once. And your minimap will now show you the optimal order of camp clears. This will be based on stats from high ranked junglers. Next, Riot will be also expanding the ping system. We have already seen this in the last dev post, so the 4 new pings are push, all in, hold, and bait. A new added bonus is that when you ping a dragon, people can vote whether they want to take it or leave it. Hopefully this will be used as a way to show your jungler who can help them, and it totally won't be used for trolling. Then, for the quality of life changes, you will get a little arrow on your screen pointing towards off-screen pings. Also, pinging a freshly placed enemy ward will also reveal its timer. On top of that, allied wards will get a new expiring indicators. Riot is also testing a new feature for recommended runes, summoner spells, and recommendations for ability leveling. There are also some tiny XP tweaks for lanes, bunch of new and updated items, out of which we have to point out one. The one that used to be my favorite caster item in the game. Rod of Ages has returned, and it is now an ability haste mythic item. And I'm pretty sure it is going to get a new icon.
But that's it for League, and so now, let's move on to what's new in TFT. Here, not much is happening. Patch 12.18 is still ongoing. Despite Riot's latest attempts to put down Dragonmancer Nunu, That thing just won't die. Besides this, there is only one more thing. On PBE, people datamined a new chibi champion. Ash. She will come from the Archer eggs, and of course, she will also get a Dragonmancer version. Well, since the time I recorded this, Riot revealed a new patch where they are buffing Dragonmancers, but more importantly, they are nerfing Nunu again. They just removed his true damage and instead buffed the consume damage by another 20%. So now, finally, a tank should be able to soak Nunu's damage and not get eaten in one go. But that's it for TFT2, so now on to Legends of Runeterra. There we get the new patch 3.16. As always, this comes with a lot of new balancing, but also two new cosmetics. Corrupted Zoe is now available alongside the other corrupted champions. This one has its own level up animation, which is quite creepy, as well as new augmented spells, which is the norm these days. With the second new cosmetic being Rugged Garen. Finally, he can join the rest of the D&D party. This one also has a new level up animation. And I have to say, his shoulder pads are massive, even for Garen. Also, even though it is the norm, I have not actually seen if Garen has an augmented ability. Maybe he actually doesn't. Well, once again, there is one more thing. The next Legends of Runeterra expansion was revealed. It is the next chapter of the Darkin saga called Domination. It was kinda obvious that it would involve Varus, simply because we know that Arclight is gonna be a skin line, and he's a Darkin. But it seems like Varus is going around the world corrupting people's weapons. I am a bit confused as to how he's doing it. Is he using blood magic or is it something else? Also, I wonder why would he be willingly corrupting weapons? Is he trying to make his own worshippers? Just like the Darkin did during the Darkin Wars? Well, whatever the case, it seems like Riot thought about the lore and the implications, because they linked every single piece of Varus's story in the description. So even though normally I don't like how Riot is forcing all champions from Legends of Runeterra to have their own duplicate followers, in this case, I am interested to see how they pull it off. But that's it for Legends of Runeterra 2, so now onto Wild Rift. There, patch 3.4 rolled out. This is the patch which we have talked about twice already. It's the one with Yone, Gwen, Vex, and Warwick. Also, there is Glorious Draven. Now that it's out, we also got to see the other new cosmetics. Here we can see all the new ranked Draven emotes, as well as two new bubbles, one for celebrating 2022, and the other one should be in the ranked store. There are also two new icons, again, one celebrating 2022, and the other one should be from the ranked season, which also comes in with a ranked border and a ranked profile, with a new spawning emblem. At least, I believe that's what it is. It could also be a trail. But that's it for Wild Rift 2, so now on to Valorant. I mean, Valorant just had the championship. So besides a new video where the devs talked about how they made Peril, or a new dev post where they talked about how they made Phoenix, there's nothing really new here. Actually, there is one more thing. Yesterday, Riot revealed a brand new skin line. And god damn, is it a good one. It is called Crimson Beast, and it has an obvious demonic theme. I have to say, I absolutely love the demonic hammer. We all know the pricing will be, well, you know, it's Valorant, but once again, it looks really good. Which closes this episode of Rift News. This week we had a bunch of Worlds news and Datamined cosmetics and Ahri. I assume there won't be much happening in the upcoming weeks because most of the focus will be on Worlds. In fact, I'm guessing we will see the new champion revealed during Worlds. And that means, especially for me, I have to do my pick-ems. I am already behind because of the predictions. I have to uphold my reputation of getting any points.